One great benefit of having a device like Surface that we are building at Microsoft is that we also have an amazing team of developers working on tools to build out solutions to help you manage and troubleshoot these devices in the long run.
One of the biggest ones is the Surface Diagnostic Toolkit for Business. This tool is extremely versatile and far-reaching because it is built by our Surface engineering team. So it dives deep into the hardware and the software. If it's a Microsoft-owned software, it'll actually repair things like Windows Update, the entire Office suite. It'll take a look at what are these challenges that you're facing and can this tool solve them. It'll, of course, check everything hardware-wise, repairing anything that's with your file system on the computer, just a very wide array of fixes that can be applied all at once.
Yeah, and you mentioned there's a wide array of fixes. If there's only a specific set of troubleshooting steps that you know or think you need to run, what's great about the SDT for Business is that we now allow you to create custom packages so that you can be very prescriptive with which troubleshooting steps you want to go through, and that helps you really hone in on what the issue may be. So what you're looking at right here is the step to create a custom package. This helps you create your custom executable to send out to end users so that when someone in accounting is having an issue with their Surface laptop, all you have to send them is this EXE and you'll get the reports back.
I mean, think about how simple that is too. Yeah. You know, someone contacts help desk, they say, hey, I have a problem, I want to solve this, here's what I'm experiencing. You simply direct them to click this and it will be fixed. Yeah. It's just kind of an amazing solution unique to Surface.
Yeah, absolutely. So what we're walking through now is that custom package creation, setting your language. Here you can also choose whether or not you would like to point the device to look for updates as a part of the troubleshooting steps. We've already talked a little about how updates are really important and vital to keeping these devices healthy in the long run. But if you use Windows Update for Business, you can have it point towards your own Windows Update server, or you can disable checking for Windows updates at all.
There's a couple of preset software troubleshooters that you can also configure as a part of this default package. One of them, of course, being the components store you see there. This cleans out that Windows SXS, which is kind of hard to say out loud, folder, and helps reduce some disk space. You also see the option to repair any file system corruption, as I mentioned earlier, and that will perform that nice check on Windows without you having to go into command prompt separately and run that file system checker. We also, of course, have the ability to reinstall the Microsoft Store. Sometimes that can be deleted. Now, this is not imposed, so if you purposefully deleted Microsoft Store, you don't need to re-add it, but it gives you that ability. It's kind of the one thing you can't get from the store because of chicken and the egg-related issues. And then, of course, there is restoring system health. And this kind of wide-reaching, but it really relies on Windows Update to make sure, is this computer healthy? Does it have everything that it needs? If there is a corrupted file, it can reach out to the update server and pull a fresh copy of that system file and make sure the device is working properly.
Logs are a really great way to dive deep into what the issue might be on this device after you've gone through those troubleshooting steps. And if you do have to send your device back for a warranty claim, it can be really helpful for our internal team to receive those logs as well so that we can help catch issues in the future as well. So on this page, you'll be able to pick and choose which logs you'd like to create as a part of this SDT.
Now, slides 6 and 7 are merely ornamental. What are you going to name it? Where do you want it to live? And then, of course, the option to create another one, all within that same tool. So that's how we can create this nice custom package that you can give to a user and say, hey, you're having this problem? Try this. It'll solve it for you. But what about just, we don't know what the problem is, and we want to simply run this tool. The SDT tools, what we call it for short, is extremely powerful. In fact, we receive a lot of devices back that are marked as defective through our warranty exchange process. This is part of the steps that we perform on those devices. And a large portion of those devices we receive back have their issues completely solved after we simply run this tool. So it can reduce your support costs, reduce tickets, if we simply run this tool first before submitting that claim. So let's walk through just a little bit about how this program works.
Yeah. So right here on the welcome screen, just a generic splash screen here. Yeah. Also, there's a spot there to tell us what you think. If you've already used the tool a little bit, we'd love to hear your feedback. We're always trying to improve on these tools as much as possible. The next step is that the new SDT for Business will check for updates. Previously, you had to go specifically back to aka.ms/toolsforit to download the new version. Now, this will check internally just to make sure that it's aware of all the new devices that are out on the market.
You're then greeted with the option to select, what is it that we're doing today? Do we want to run every single test? Do you know a little bit about what it is we're trying to do? So you can select your options here. If you perform every test, you'll get this really nice kind of health checkup view. This will show you via red and green and other color coding, which is very clear, where you might be experiencing some problems. It'll outline what those are and then give you the option to immediately solve for them. All problems, of course, but the ones that it's able to solve for, it will even perform that repair automatically.
Yeah, absolutely. And also you'll see there that there's an option to quickly open up the log file so that if there is a red flag, you might be able to just on the spot correct it, which would be great.
Now this is made available as a part of our Surface Tools for IT, and you can access this by going to aka.ms/toolsforit. When you go there, you'll see a wide array of different programs, and this is part of that package. So that is part of your homework, is go there, give it a try, and please let us know what you think. On the slide here, you'll see surfacediagnostics@microsoft.com. That is our listening mechanism to hear from you, the people in the front lines who are actually using this in an organization. Does it have the tools you need? Are there things that you would like it to do that it doesn't currently do? We want to hear from you and make those adjustments to the program as needed. So the Surface Diagnostic Toolkit is a very powerful tool that has been built by our Surface Engineering team for you, the people that are responsible for supporting so many of our devices. We want to make sure that you have the tools you need to effectively do your job, and that the users who receive Surface have reduced downtime and are able to be productive every day.